Hi, friends. Today I want to paint a leaf. I prepared this with a little sketch. I did the sketch with a titanium white, freehand. And at first we will do our underpainting. Hi, Hemmchen. Hi, Dina. Those leaves are relatively hard, but if they lay too long in a dry area, they start to break. Maybe I have to prepare it with some acrylic medium on the back or on the front. Hi, Leslie. So this would be my base layer. And I start with the blue. I use a phthalo blue green shade. My white base layer, I painted with titanium white. On this leaf, I just started painting, but I think if you store them in a dry area, I firstly planned to paint this, but it lay a couple of hours in my warm studio and it starts to break. There is a little break. I think you have to prepare it with some transparent acrylic medium that they stay flexible. It's from an evergreen bush. Bush. And I did this today the first time. Hi, Vanessa. And it dries a bit slower on this leaf. Because I think the leaf doesn't absorb any moisture. The reference photo from this painting is from Pixabay. I will go the next step with the yellow. I use cadmium yellow. Be careful with cadmium paints, they are toxic. Hi Linda. Thank you. It's all about the shadow. It's cadmium. It's dangerous. You have to be careful that you don't get it on your hands. It's a very dangerous pigment. It's vibrant and it's a very brilliant color, but you have to be careful with this. So the lower body of the Hi Grandma Missy, the lower body needs some grayish tone, and for those I add some burnt umber. And I mix the burnt umber with the blue, with the phthalo blue, and with a bit of white. a little bit of white. Now I mix my burnt umber with the phthalo blue without the white, and it will create a dark tone, nearly black. And I switch from my size 0 brush to my script liner. And I start to paint at first those dots. And then these black areas. It don't has to be super perfect with a reference photo. It's nature. It's everything a bit different. We need now a bit burnt umber in the yellow to tone it a bit down. And I will darken the edges a bit. A bit more brown. Hi Karl-Heinz. Bist du aus Deutschland? And we have to paint some tiny strokes. Thank you. And some strokes here too, but they I will paint in blue. And the same we have to do here in the on the upper wings, lower wings. We have to work a bit on the head. I paint now the tentacles. antennas or And now the fun part comes. You can do it with just water, but or you have those glazing medium. It's a bit easier, but it will work with water too. I need some fresh burnt umber and I think my blue is fresh enough, and I do a bit of this glazing medium on my palette. I mix my burnt umber with my ultramarine, with my phthalo blue to a dark tone, and mix in the glazing medium to get a transparent color. A transparent paint layer. I switch to my size 0 brush and I paint in the shadow. The glazing medium is also a bit drying, slowing slows the dry time. It doesn't dry so quick. You can also use this mix to set some values. And I think this butterfly is ready to fly. What do you think? You can add some highlights to get it more pop. Just a tiny bit of titanium white. I think I like the result. I hope you enjoyed this unusual rock painting. And I think I have to figure out how to prepare those leaves. I have enough of them in my garden. And yeah, it's easier to get them instead of collecting rocks. Yes, I don't know what to paint next. Maybe some ladybugs or a landscape. I see you in the next video. Please give me thumbs up and I wish you a good evening. Ciao.